Today's SportsFigure tutorial is entitled Detecting Server-Side Prototype Pollution Without Polluted Property Reflection. To solve the lab, we must trigger a noticeable but non-destructive change in the server's behavior in order to confirm a prototype pollution vulnerability. We are going to implement the three detection techniques presented in the SportsFigure documentation. But first, let's access the lab. Log in with the provided credentials. Winner, Peter. Also make sure that you are proxying traffic through Burp. Once logged in, click the Submit button to update the billing and delivery address. Now, go to Burp Proxy HTTP History and look for the Post Change Address request. Send this request to Repeater. As you can see, our billing data is being sent to the server as a JSON object. The server also responds with a JSON object representing our user. The first thing we would try is to pollute the object prototype with a new property, let's say foo, with the value bar. For this, we must add a new property to the JSON object __proto__ with the value of an object that contains a property foo with the value bar. Unfortunately, the injected property is not being reflected. However, this does not mean that the application is not vulnerable to prototype pollution. This is where detection comes in. Keep in mind that the website is using the Express framework. We have three ways in which we can try to confirm prototype pollution in a non-destructive way. Status code override. The Express framework allows developers to set custom HTTP response statuses. In the case of errors, the JavaScript server may issue a generic HTTP response, but include an error object in the response body. Let's try to generate an error response by breaking the JSON syntax. I'll just delete this comma here. As you can see, the server responded with a 500 internal server error response. However, the body of the response contains this error object with a status property with the value 400. Fix the JSON object and try polluting the object prototype with a status property set to a value between 400 and 599. If the value is not between these numbers, node defaults to a 500 status. This value comes from the code here. This should be a less than sign, not greater than. Send the request. Now break the JSON syntax again. This time, when we send the request, we can see that the status of the error changed to our injected value. This means that we have managed to pollute the object prototype, so prototype pollution is possible. The lab is solved. JSON space override. The Express framework provides a JSON spaces option, which enables you to configure the number of spaces used to indent any JSON data in the response. In the response section of Burp, click the Raw tab to see the full response message in its raw form. This way, we will see if the JSON spaces option was indeed added to the object prototype. As you can see, the JSON object seems to contain no spaces for now. Pollute the object prototype and set the JSON spaces value to something like 100. Resend the request. As you can see, the indentation changes, so we have again confirmed that prototype pollution is possible. Changing the value to 0 leads to the default response. The lab is solved. Keep in mind that this pollution has been fixed in Express version 4.17.4. Charset override. For this detection method, we are going to UTF-7 encode the value of one of the reflected properties. Let's say country. I will use the Hackverter extension to encode the property's value, UK, to UTF-7. Set the value of country to this encoded string. When we send the request, the string is reflected as is because the server won't use UTF-7 decoding by default. Try polluting the object prototype with a content type property that sets the charset value to UTF-7. Send the request once to pollute the object prototype and again to see if this worked. If it did, the server should decode our UTF-7 encoded value back to UK. And it does. Again, we have confirmed that prototype pollution is possible, and we have solved the lab. This is it for today's tutorial. See you next time!